接着聚焦国际，俄乌战争陷入了旷日持久的拉锯战，惨绝人寰的平民屠杀和性暴力事件不断的浮上台面，引起了公愤。美国总统拜登星期三宣布向乌克兰提供8亿美元的额外军事援助，包括供应重型火炮和直升机，阻止俄罗斯进一步入侵乌克兰东部。分析员认为，这一次的援助凸显出美国政策上的转变，意义重大。
美国总统拜登和乌克兰总统泽连斯基13号通话后，拜登发出声明，向乌克兰提供新一波总额高达8亿美元的军事援助，当中包括火炮、榴炮弹、装甲运兵车和直升机等重型武器，以提升乌克兰的抗敌能力。美国五角大楼发言人科比在记者会说明，华府这一次供应给乌克兰的武器是前所未有的重型兵器，除了武器支援，还会派遣美军指导乌克兰军队使用这些武器。但他重申，美国不会向乌克兰派兵，也不会有美国飞行员驾驶直升机飞抵乌克兰的情况。
So we do anticipate that some of these items will require some additional training for Ukrainians. We're still working through what those options are going to look like, what that training is going to look like, how many U.S. troops are going to be involved in it, where is it going to be, how long, it's going to depend. We're still working our way through that, but we believe that we can put together appropriate training for some of these systems very, very quickly.
美国军事策略分析员约翰·史宾塞对白宫的决定感到欣慰，并认为提供进一步军事援助的决定显示出美国对俄乌战争政策上的转变。尤其新一波的援助武器列表上有许多战斗力坚强的重型武器，绝对能够帮助乌克兰抵御莫斯科军队。
In a howitzer is a very large artillery round that when it impacts, it can really hurt a military formation. Even inside of a tank, it can really mess them up. So you want systems like that that can fire, you know, 30, 40 kilometers away from where you are.Trying to break up the military long before it gets close to you. And that's what Ukrainians need at this moment. They need to destroy the Russian convoys before they even get to the cities or near to the locations they want to take. That's why it's one of the top requests right now, because they're so powerful and so far reaching, that they can destroy so much especially in the open.
专家也认为，乌克兰军队有足够的韧性和国际支援，有望将俄罗斯军队赶回克里姆林宫。只要乌克兰成功抵御，在世界的眼光中，俄罗斯就再也不是各国想象中高不可攀的超级军队。尤其这一场战争已经在经济和军事上给俄罗斯带来沉重的打击，俄国人民未来必须付出惨重的代价，才能让国家恢复生气。俄乌战争爆发至今，美国已经向乌克兰提供了总额高达25亿美元的军事援助。马新社电视综合报道。